Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use Elastic Beanstalk. In this exact example, we are going to be creating a basic Express application and then uploading that manually to Elastic Beanstalk. However, the same concept will apply to any other type of web server. To get started, we can click on Create Application right here, the orange button. We can then enter an application name. Mine will just be Tutorial Demo. Scrolling down, we got platform, and this is going to be the actual language that you want to use. Mine is Node.js, and the defaults are fine for me right here with Node 12. Now, we have to upload our own code. So to do that, I'm going to go into VS Code, and I'm going to open up my console, and I'm going to run npm init-y. This is going to initialize a basic project for us. I'm also going to make a new file called server.js. So I'm going to paste in this very basic Express application. This is something that if you had your own application, your own web server, you don't have to worry about. You would just use that. However, a very quick rundown is going to be we're going to import Express and use it in an application. We're then going to get a port variable. The capitalization of this is important, and we're going to get that from an environment variable. And in Node.js, we get that through process.env. So this is assuming that the environment variable process.env.port exists. And this is actually something that Elastic Beanstalk will give us. And so if that doesn't exist, for example, for local development, we're going to set that equal to 3000. However, no matter what language or server you're using, it is important that your port is from process.env.port, or however you get environment variables in your language or library. In this exact case, this is how we do it in Node.js. Line 5, we're just going to console log that. So when we look at our logs, which I'll show you how to do soon, we can then see exactly what the port is. Line 7. It's going to simply say whenever we reach the home page, just render hello world to the screen. And line 9 is actually going to create the server and listen on a specified port. So we can save this and we can run npm install express because this is a third-party dependency that we are actually importing here. Now we can run this with node server.js. We're just going to make sure that this actually works. It says example app listening on localhost 3000. So if we copy this, we can actually open this in a new tab. And we see hello world right there. So this is working. We can go ahead and close that. And we can actually close out of our console because we don't need that anymore. Now we need to zip up the entire project. So going back to VS Code, we can review this in File Explorer. And we can send all of this to a compressed zipped folder. We see that right there. I'm going to copy the path that this is at. And we can go ahead and close this. Going back to Elastic Beanstalk, we have local file selected. So we can click on Choose File. We're going to navigate to where we want, and we're going to select our file, which is the .zip, and click open. Now at the bottom left, it'll show a percentage for how long it takes to upload. This obviously uploaded very fast because it's a very simple application. However, yours might take a few minutes. We could then click on create application once it's done uploading. Now you're going to be sent to a screen like this. And this screen sometimes has a problem with auto updating. Sometimes it doesn't. So this is going to take a few minutes, as it says at the top. But if it's taking 7 to 10 minutes, maybe more, then you might want to just refresh it every now and again to make sure everything's working well. So after a few minutes of waiting, I'm at a page like this. We see a check mark here, and right here we see an actual link. So if we click on this, it's then going to open up our application and we see hello world. So everything seems to work. So let's say that something didn't work. If we close that, on the left we can go to our logs, and then we can go to request logs at the top right. And we can get the full logs, which will download a .zip, or we can request the last 100 lines. Typically, that's all the information you need to actually debug the problem, so we'll select that. We then see this download right here, which will actually just open it in a new tab, and we see all of the logs right here. We do a search for port. We see our console log right here, which is port 8080. And then we also see our other console log, example app listening at localhost 8080. And so everything seems to be working. And this is how you would debug some of the problems. Going back, let's say that we made a change to our application. Upload and deploy would be the button you'd click. And then you can choose the file, the version label, like let's say version 1.1 or something like that, and then you can deploy. Another thing you can do is, let's say you deploy something to a production environment, and let's say you found a bug and you want to revert back to a previous change. In this pop-up here, you have application versions page. If you click on that, you would see a number of different versions that you can redeploy to. However, right now we just have this one. So if we were to click on this and then click on deploy, we would then deploy that. But obviously it doesn't make sense because this is what we currently have. So that's how you were able to revert back to a previous version. And that's pretty much it. This is a basic introduction to Elastic Beanstalk. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.